Everyone knows that to succeed in professional gaming, you know, one of the things that you really need on your side, guys, is a high FPS, right? And so with more frames per second, you're going to be able to see things faster and react quicker and with a higher level of accuracy. But not everybody can afford a brand new graphics card to play Fortnite at over 60 frames per second, right? Butcher Crunch Tommy, where you at, your motivation guy? That's right, I'm back. And today, we're going to be helping all of you guys out who are on slower PCs and even last gen consoles who just can't get their FPS up to the level of the pros. Are you guys ready for this? Let's get this going. When it comes to winning more fights on low FPS, the first step that you need to take is actually understanding what sort of disadvantage you're at while you're playing on low FPS. And so without that level of understanding, it's just pretty much impossible to really combat the impact of being on a lower end system and just playing on low FPS. And so the biggest and most obvious disadvantage that you are going to find while playing on a low FPS system is that your game isn't going to be as smooth as your opponent's, which itself presents its own unique disadvantages. First of all, it's going to be a whole lot harder when you end up getting into a close quarters fight, especially if you got a low and this unstable FPS that jitters all over the place. So if you're fighting up close with a low FPS machine, your enemies could pull off a shoulder peek and just take a shot at you without you even seeing it happen. And so the best way to combat this scenario would be to try and deny any right-handed peeks when your opponent tries to position themselves for them if you just find yourself up close. Realistically though, like, you should actually be trying to play at a distance when you're noticing fewer FPS drops instead of trying to ram your barrel down the enemy's throat. Okay, so another disadvantage that you're going to have on low FPS is the fact that if you manage to make it into the end game of something like a tournament or a scrim, then things are going to be much harder for you than any of your enemies. Historically speaking, end games in competitive Fortnite have always been a bit laggy, no matter what system you're really running. And in end game scenario, there is a clutter all over the map and builds are being placed down almost constantly. And because of that, a lot of systems can really struggle to keep up, even if they're on high end computers. On your low end system that already struggles with keeping its frame counts up, the end games are going to be just like a real struggle for you to get through. So this really means one of two things. You're going to either, you know, be very precise and forward thinking in the late game, making sure you're always on the dead side of the map so that you can avoid fights right until the end and the number of builds really being placed down is reduced, meaning your system will be able to really keep up with things a little bit better. Or you're just gonna have to have practice really hard, like much harder than anyone on a more up-to-date system. So really the secret is doing both of these things, right? Because no matter how you practice, you're never going to be able to fully account for the RNG nature of frame drops. You could be in the middle of a really, really good fight, and then a stutter will send your crosshairs flying wildly all over the place, which obviously isn't going to be a great way to fight somebody, right? Overall, man, like, there are just a wide variety of disadvantages to having low FPS, and we'd probably be here all day if we went over every single one of them. So the real trick is really going to be taking your time to identify each and every one of those disadvantages and then begin brainstorming ways to really combat them. All right, so if you need some help, like brainstorming what your biggest disadvantages are in Fortnite, you definitely need to go over to ProGuides.com. All right, so we've got pro coaches ready and waiting to train you one-on-one with tailored feedback to really help you guys improve fast. No matter what disadvantage you end up uncovering and just figuring out ways to get over them, there's one thing that you're going to end up needing to do anyway, and that's thinking ahead. Okay, so as we mentioned earlier, due to the nature of playing on a low FPS system, you simply are not going to see as many frames as your opponent. And that means it's going to be a lot more challenging for you to manage to play fast and aggressive. And so as a result of this, you're going to need to be a lot more tactical, which means you need to be thinking ahead in all aspects of the game. And so whether that be understanding that a player has the potential to make a right-handed peek on you in the early stages of the game, meaning that, you know, you should try and just find some way around the situation, or it's just simply deciding not to make an edit in the late game so that you can focus on securing more placement points. And so thinking ahead on low FPS is different to thinking ahead when you're on a higher end machine. Like, you shouldn't just be thinking something along the lines of, oh, I guess I see a team and I'm on low FPS, so I shouldn't fight them. You also need to be thinking ahead in actual fights themselves. Like, okay, so since trios are the primary game mode at the moment, we're gonna use a team scenario as an example. All right, so let's just say that you and the rest of your trio team are in the middle of a team fight, and somehow you manage to get a wall on an opposing player. Since you have low FPS, instead of just trying to take a peek on the player by yourself, it would be probably a lot better, you know, for you to really move to really call it out to a teammate who has a better system and a higher FPS so that they can just come and just support you in the fight. This decision can be the difference between winning or losing the fight due to your peak disadvantage on lower FPS. So this is just one example of a specific situation where thinking ahead and taking time to coordinate with your teammates can be a pretty big benefit in helping you win fights on low FPS. So there are many more ways you can do it out there. You just need to find them and really just work it out. All right, so next up, we have something that is at the core of any pro Fortnite player's ability, and that's peace control. So whether you have low FPS or high FPS, piece control is an incredibly important element to fighting in Fortnite. And getting good at that is really the only way to succeed at the highest ranks of the game. And so with that being said, guys, it's actually even more important when it comes to players on low FPS. You know, generally speaking, it's going to be a lot harder for you to be able to build well while you're on low FPS. And it's going to be made even harder by being stuck in stressful situations like a build fight. If you're someone that regularly has to play on low FPS because of your PC or console, a good first step to really take increasing your chances of winning a fight is to focus up and perfect your piece control ability. And so by doing this, you're actually going to be able to accomplish two things at once. First and foremost, I mean, you're actually going to be managing to improve an essential part of competitive Fortnite. So if you ever manage to upgrade your system, you're going to be in a pretty good place when your FPS improves. Secondly, though, like, you're also lessening your disadvantage by prioritizing improvement on a portion of the game that is so challenging on low FPS. Overall, man, like, as a result of the building aspect of Fortnite being so prevalent in the competitive scene, there's really no real way for you to get away from build fighting. And so by forcing yourself to master piece control and building up that muscle memory, guys, you're going to give yourself that absolute best possible chance of coming out victorious in any fight. But your question army, okay, guys, it's time for the question of the day. Today, we want to know how low your FPS is. Like, how many frames per second do you average in a game of Fortnite? Let us know in the comments down below, and we're going to check all of them out. All right, back to the video. Okay, so now that you understand some of the ways that you can combat your low FPS and increase your ability in Fortnite, let's talk about some of the ways that you can actually raise your FPS to really try and lessen the disadvantage. So to increase your FPS in Fortnite, you're going to need to find the perfect graphic settings, which will give your PC a bit of a break and allow you to bump up those frame counts just a bit. Okay, so for a start, if you're a PC player and you're not playing on performance mode already, then you really need to do that, okay? Because it's going to improve your frame rate by a whole lot. With Epic's own test using an integrated Intel UHG graphics 620, which is like one of the slowest GPUs out there at the moment, alongside an old Intel i5 CPU and only 8GB of RAM, they were able to improve their FPS from a low 24 FPS all the way up to 61 FPS. And so that's a massive improvement, and one that really anybody on PC can really take full advantage of. But there are some other little tricks that you can do as well to increase that improvement even further. Whether you're on PC or a console, you have the ability to turn off the recording of your replays. Okay, so if you turn this setting off, it's going to put less strain on your system, which obviously will lead to an increase in your FPS. All right, so the final tip that we have in improving your FPS is making sure that your system, whether you play on console or PC, is running at a constant cool temperature. So whenever your system is too hot, the system throttles back, which decreases your FPS. So to ensure your system is running at peak performance, guys, make sure it's not getting too hot. All right, Bunch of Crunch Army, hope you guys still here. First of all, identify and understand what your disadvantages as a low FPS player actually are, and then just brainstorm ways to really combat any of those disadvantages. Second, you have to start thinking ahead all the time. You know, whether it be avoiding edit plays in the late game, knowing that you're at a disadvantage, or just working on communicating with teammates early and often in team fights. Thinking ahead will keep you alive. Third, you have to master your piece control, guys. We say it all the time, it's so important. Prioritizing practicing this skill above anything else is going to be the most effective way to combat low FPS. And finally, make sure to utilize some of our FPS boosting tips to try and improve your FPS to its absolute limit, all right? There's no use really trying to play on higher settings if your FPS is just going to suffer as a result. All right, guys, those are the four tips that we think is going to help you the most when it comes to winning more fights on low FPS. Which of these fights do you think will help you the most if you're a low FPS player? Hey, if you guys enjoyed the video, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and man, I just want to say, believe in yourself, because if you don't believe in yourself, who will? Hey, connect with me on my Instagram at yourmotivationguy, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.